This is KCRA 3 News at 4.
And here's something we haven't seen or heard in quite some time. Rain falling in the valley this morning. I love that sound. Mm-hmm. This video was from downtown Sacramento overnight. After 66 days without measurable rain, we have finally broken that dry streak. The rain arrived just in time for the morning commute. This is what it looked like in Roseville along Douglas Boulevard this morning. Drivers, of course, had to turn on the windshield wipers for the first time in a long time. That was real rainfall, not just the nuisance rain that just dirties everything. Yeah. That was all good stuff.
So at the same time, a small plane was flying across the gray skies, equipped with some tools for a special assignment. KCRA 3 meteorologist Heather Waldman shows us what that plane was doing.
Yeah, it was working on a story at Sacramento Executive Airport yesterday when this aircraft passed by on its way to the hangar. My photographer and I noticed these odd attachments on the wings. You can see them right there. So we asked the pilot about them. It turns out that plane is a cloud seeding aircraft, and it was flying through this morning's rain. The cloud seeding today was done by SMUD as a way to help increase stream flows to allow for more hydroelectric power generation. Here's the basic science. Clouds form when billions of tiny water vapor particles condense onto dust and other microscopic particles to form water droplets. Those dust particles are called cloud condensation nuclei. Big phrase there. So you can think of them as cloud seeds. Every cloud has them, but not every cloud has enough to produce rain. That's where cloud seeding comes in. It's a weather modification technique that adds more of these tiny particles to the lower part of the atmosphere. That's done with aircraft like what you just saw or ground-based generators. The goal is to make the clouds more effective rain and snow producers. Silver iodide is the most commonly used cloud seed, and while silver is a very toxic heavy metal in large quantities, environmental research shows that cloud seeding is not likely to be harmful to wildlife, although it may reduce the growth of algae and other bacteria in freshwater systems. Still, cloud seeding operations are carefully monitored to ensure that it's safe for the environment and for us. But now the question. Does it work? Cloud seeding has been used off and on by many countries since the 1940s, but only recently did research confirm that, yeah, cloud seeding can cause a cloud to produce rain or snow when it otherwise would not have. According to Caitlin Bedner, who manages SMUD's cloud seeding program, cloud seeding projects have resulted in precipitation increases between an average of 3% and 10%. But there are still big questions about just how economical this practice is. I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman for KCRA 3 News.
All right, so Heather, I don't know if I would ace the test at the end, but I got enough out of that to be able to ask you this. Is this something that could help with our drought by adding more water, more rain?
Yeah, a lot of people have that idea, but no, this wouldn't be a practical option because in order for it to work, you first need to have the clouds that are large enough to potentially produce precipitation. So those high fair weather clouds that we've seen a lot of lately and that we tend to see more of during the warm season, they just wouldn't be able to make rain or snow with or without seeding. SMUD's cloud seeding manager told me that their ability to cloud seed varies from season to season and is highly dependent on very specific weather conditions.
Okay. All right. Makes sense. Thanks, Heather.